could just tell the second one and stop there so we could sort of have more of a back and forth. But there was a... One of my readers sent me an email, because, you know, they'll just send us little emails of, oh, here's an interesting article I read, etc. You know, maybe you want to put it up on the blog. And it was about in Chicago, from one of the big papers, that the police had gotten a warning. And the article is all about the local police, right? Not about politics or anything. The local police have gotten a warning that you can go online and you can buy anybody's cell phone records, a month worth of who they called and who's called them, for $85. Anybody's. And they warned the police, be careful, because, you know, criminals may use this to see who your sources are. You know, they find out you're a detective, buy your records, and look and see if any of their friends' phone numbers are there, and if they are, they'll kill them. So my reader sent it to me thinking, I think my reader even thought, you know, what would this do to politics? You know, you buy the other guy's phone records. I wrote a story trying to add a little value to the story and frame it in a way that would be, because I thought this was outrageous and it needs to change, right? So I tried to frame it in a political way, thinking people in Washington would understand the concept of, you know, the Republicans buying a top Democratic aide's or a senator's phone records. Wrote up the story. It didn't really, a friend of mine on CNN, but who was like covering the blogs, you know, she did a little mention in her blog segment on CNN, didn't go anywhere. And I was kind of pissed off going, no, this is a bigger story. And this is sort of a side point here, which is, you know, to some degree, to be able to do these things well, you have to be pretty good at doing this to start with. It's not like the internet makes you a good activist. You know, I mean, you've got to develop a good, almost a reporter's sense in your gut of what's a story. So you see something that happens and you go, oh, not only is this horrible, but oh, this is newsworthy. You know, people are going to be angry. You know, you have to kind of know what's going to work. Well, I decided, okay, we have to make this a story because this is, you know, bullshit, that this is even legal. And I went to the website and tried. A friend of mine tried. Basically, you put your credit card, you know, $85. You know, I put my name, phone, you know, whatever you do with a credit card, right? Address, blah, blah, blah. And the cell phone of whoever's records you want, I put in my friends. 2 days later, I got an email, all of his cell phone calls. But it was just the phone numbers. He called, who called him, how much time. Bizarre. So, but we thought, okay, how can we do better? So first I called the advocacy groups that handle these issues. At the time, probably still is today. One is called EPIC and one is EFF. It was EFF. And it was EPIC especially I talked to. And I said, you know, are you guys aware of this? Oh, yeah, you know, we've been trying for like 4 or 5 years to change this. You know, we've been working with Congress, but, you know, I'm like, this would seem kind of easy. You know, people would freak if they knew you could do this. You know, I said, why don't you, like, try to blow this up? Well, no, you know, we like to kind of work quietly, and we're working with Congress, and this kind of crap. Which, again, is a recurring theme of any of the work you do, working with a party or organizations that everyone kind of wants to be nice. And I was like, okay, well, I'm going to do something. So I figured I was going to go, again, to make this a story, to make it relevant for people, but also to make it sexy so it would be a bigger story. I figured I'm going to buy somebody's phone records who's famous. Why not? You know? And I thought it through and said, okay, it's got to be better to have somebody political, better to have somebody on the left, because if I buy somebody on the right, first, I wasn't totally sure if this, I mean, I knew it was available, but the legality of it still scared me. So I said, I want it to be somebody on the left, so at least if it happens, they'll know I was doing it as an activist, not as a left-winger going after a right-winger, you know. So I tried to buy a bunch of journalists, famous people stuff, couldn't get anything. The one I finally got, and I got it through a friend who used to work for him, was the phone number of Wesley Clark, who was a sort of repeated Democratic presidential candidate, one well-liked, never made it to the top, but, you know, always made it to the top three or four. But he was also in the 1990s the Supreme Allied Commander of NATO. So, good, you know, general, pretty good senior guy for the news. I thought, okay, this is pretty good. 2 days later, get his phone records. It includes a phone number that I recognize as the Washington Post. So I called, because you know your local newspaper. I called it and get the voicemail of one of the military reporters. Now, interesting, just because, you know, I know what day he talked to her. You could look if you wanted a couple days later and see, did she do any stories in the next week or two? Where there were military sources not named. I mean, you could possibly find out. There were some phone numbers in places I did not recognize at all, which had to be some clients of his, but they clearly weren't clients in Western Europe, because I know those codes, it wasn't. I didn't want to go farther because I felt bad. Called him, explained it to him. He wasn't happy, but you know, I told him I'm going to go do this. And I posted his phone records on my site, but you know, I blacked out everything but the last two digits because I wanted to make sure there was nothing identifying. But still, people like examples. They like, you know, a picture of the thing, like even a document. You could write about a document, take a picture of the document with your phone and put that up there too. Because it's in English we say it's a smoking gun. You know, gun shoots, smoke's coming out, it means, ooh, something happened. People love to see a thing that goes, oh my God, it is real, versus, you know, I saw it. Anyway, put the story up there, explain the whole thing, got his nice little picture from NATO and his little general outfit. That evening, three of the four national networks covered the story. Three of the four. One of them found a fascinating angle thinking of women who were victims of domestic violence and whether by looking at the phone logs, somebody could figure out where they were. You know, are they making a number of local calls in a certain area, like their boyfriend or their husband? I mean, it's sort of an interesting new angle they took on it, which was also kind of smart. Again, the media thinking the same thing I'm telling you. What new angle can I take on the story to make it new that'll make it more newsworthy? Well, a bunch of states across the country started investigating. The attorneys general, which are the, like the minister of justice of a state, basically, okay? You know, in charge of the law there, started investigating in their state what could they do legislatively. Local news people in different cities started doing broadcasts on, you know, in Boston was one I remember, you know, we bought the phone numbers of our producer. Could they do it to you? But every state started doing this. By the end of the year, Congress passed the law. Bush signed it. It's illegal. I got credit for it. It was like literally people said, we did it. These groups did nothing for 5 years. I understand that groups have restrictions on them because they have board of directors who might think this is crazy. But, you know, there is a lot you can do with this, but it does take being creative, but it's more than that. It takes sort of having a sense of the media. And I've even, you know, at one point I even wrote freelance, you know, meaning I wrote sort of occasional columns for The Economist, for example. So I do have a sort of media background, but I think it's important to develop that in yourself or find somebody who does have that, that's got that gut for what's news, because it'll help you to identify the story that will work, but it'll also help you to realize what's not in the story. You say, okay, what can we do to make this sexier, to make it new, because the reporters will say we already reported on it, you know? So, anyway, I mean, I'm going to stop there because there's a ton more, but I want to sort of get into more talking with you guys and Sonny and just see if there's more, you know, more lessons. But it really is, it's amazing how you can blow stuff up, and I don't believe it's just, you know, the U.S. I mean, they've done it there. And we've seen it, and even here I know there have been a couple stories that Bjorn and Robin and some others have told us, and Robin Zachary, of things they've done that have, you know, they have gotten news. You know, so I mean, it can be done here, too.